everyone, GiGi of GiGi Eats Celebrities, and today I have waffle iron here to help me make a recipe that is so unique, you'll be scratching your head for days. I am going to be making meat waffles with a very specific meat, actually. I am going to be using the Honest Bison. This is 100% grass-fed and grass-finished bison. Now, this is very important when you're looking for a bison or a beef. It's upside down. Let me turn this right side up. Typically, all of the beef and bison that you find in the stores might be grass-fed initially, but in the last couple months of its life, is pushed on over to a feedlot where it's fed corn and grains that have a lot of antibiotics and a bunch of other crap that fatten up the animal super quickly, causing the meat to get this marbling that a lot of people love. Unfortunately, that marbling is full of omega-6 fatty acids, which are not good for your heart. Now, if the beef and bison is fully pasteurized all the way until slaughtering, it has far more omega-3 fatty acids than omega-6 fatty acids. And hopefully you guys all know that omega-3 fatty acids are very healthy for you, which is why eating grass-fed and grass-finished meat is so important. I'm like hunched over screaming at my computer because I want you guys to know that grass-fed and grass-finished meat is the only way you should go. I'm gonna like throw the meat at my camera so you guys know to never just purchase conventionally raised animals from the supermarket. It drives me so crazy to see that stuff in the grocery store. You have no idea. It makes me cringe, actually. Unfortunately, so many people are just not educated in this realm and they just go for it because the price tag is attractive and then they throw the steaks on the grill. You're having a barbecue and you invited omega-6 fatty acids and carcinogens. Yeah. Sounds like a good time to me. Actually, no, meat waffles sound awesome, so I'm gonna get this recipe going. Just flow with me on this one, just flow. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do is get a bowl. This is my trusty bowl I use in every single recipe. Don't worry, I wash it. I'm gonna stick this bison in the bowl. While you could certainly eat this bison without any seasonings, just simple salt and pepper, I'm gonna add a bit of a flavor profile to it to give it a little zest. To my bowl of ground bison, I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of parsley, 1/2 teaspoon of allspice. I'm also gonna use 1/2 teaspoon of ground cinnamon, 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper to give it a little heat, a little black pepper, some salt, but of course, and I'm going to use about 1/4 cup of diced up white onion, pretty much about this much onion. Now, since I like to get dirty, I'm gonna stick my hands in the bowl and really mix it all together. You can use a fork if you want, you can use a spoon, get someone else to do it if you don't like touching ground meat. But I actually really like it, so I'm gonna go for it. It smells really good. I've never had this combination of flavors before. Cinnamon and meat, it's very interesting. However, I'm making this meat into waffles, and waffles have cinnamon. There you go. So grass-fed and grass-finished bison is also lower in calories than the grain-finished version, which means that it's less fatty, and this cuts the cooking time in half. You don't really want to overcook bison, so cooking it in a waffle iron is going to be a very interesting experiment because, you know, waffle irons tend to cook things all the way through. We're gonna see what happens, and hopefully it holds true to form, and it looks like a waffle, and yay! My experiment worked. So here is my ground meat, ready to go. Probably eat it raw. It brings me back to the days when I was younger, and I loved to eat it raw. Plop this waffle iron in. I have to make sure to liberally coat my waffle iron with some olive oil spray so the bison doesn't stick in there. I want it to look like a damn waffle. Here we go. This is my experiment. Can you hear it? Can you hear it sizzling away? Now, I'm gonna close it up. And I am going to give this about 5-6 minutes. Really hope it works. Woo! It looks cool. It looks cool. It's cooking. So that's a good sign. See this? Woo! All right. I am going to now see if I can take this out. It smells so good, and I really think that this is pretty much done. What do I use to take the waffle out of the waffle iron? I don't know. Ah! Maybe a fork? I don't know where to put these things. Okay. What's going on here? You know what? It's not sticking, so I feel like this is going to come out actually pretty easily. Gonna work. We can do it. We can do it. Woo! This is freaking cool. I made waffles! I made know all of you were super skeptical about my meat waffles, but check these babies out. Meat waffle, hello. Now, the true test here is to see if these actually taste good. Oh, and by the way, what's a waffle without syrup? So I made egg yolk syrup. I just, you know, cracked an egg yolk on top. We're gonna try this right now. Yeah, buddy. Oh my gosh, all the flavorings. Oh, Well, that confirms it. I really am a genius because this is so freaking good. So meaty, so dense. The flavor combination of the cinnamon and the allspice and the cayenne pepper just bring out the nice, lean bison flavor so much more. I'm really impressed. You know what this would be really great for? It would be wonderful for breakfast in bed for Dad. You know, Father's Day is coming up. This is perfection. The Honest Bison also has some bratwurst you can serve it with. This is top notch, top notch. Now, if you're not a big fan of red meat, you can always go the white meat route. You might even be able to put some fish in this waffle iron. I don't know, that could be my next recipe, just you wait. However, I don't think I can wait any longer. The smells and the aromas that are happening on this plate right now need to go in my mouth. So I have to go do that right now. What you should do, however, is go subscribe to my channel, then get to your local grocery store, pick up grass-fed and grass-finished meat, or head to thehonestbison.com and order some meat there, and get waffling. Yes! Success in the kitchen. I love when this happens. Woo! Okay, meat waffles going in my face. Egg and meat is just a great combination of awesome.
But seriously. I am one sexy eater, that's for sure.